If you're serious about learning Adobe Premiere Pro or use it daily and just want easy reminders of how to use it, Editor's Keys might just have the perfect product for you. I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, here today with a new keyboard review. This keyboard isn't the standard gamery mechanical keyboard with all the LEDs and such though. This is a fairly standard chiclet keyboard, but it's backlit and has all of the available keyboard shortcuts for Adobe Premiere Pro CC labeled on the keys. All you have to do is look down and you can see many more features and commands to do in Premiere Pro than you may have even known existed. The build quality is pretty nice, plastic but durable feeling. The keys all feel pretty solid and consistent. The keyboard is very small, however. It's very similar to the basic Apple keyboard that comes with iMacs, so if you're comfortable with that one, you'll definitely be fine here. But it's quite the contrast to my bulky mechanical keyboards that I've been using for the past 5 or so years. Quite different ergonomics, and my wrist rests are all way too high for it. But the keys have pretty short travel distance and feel pretty good. The board holds up well to a lot of pressure while typing. Basic grip points line the bottom, and they even manage to include gripping on the risers. It drives me nuts when keyboard manufacturers don't provide any anti-slip material on the risers. It still slips with those out. Good job here. The USB cable is not detachable, sadly. The backlight is nice. It's basic white with the typical blue-leaning feel from LEDs. You can turn the backlighting off altogether or change a couple levels of brightness. That's all the control you get, however, and brightness levels aren't too different. Having the most common keyboard shortcuts in front of you saves you time from having to look up the shortcut or figure out how to do something. Just look down and it's there. It seems silly, but even for a pretty experienced Premiere Pro editor like myself, I still picked up a few things from regular use of this keyboard. And if you don't want to invest on a full keyboard, they have keyboard covers for MacBooks for the entire Adobe suite, along with Ableton, DaVinci Resolve, Final Cut, Avid, and even more. They also have a plethora of other keyboards for audio, video editing programs, and even graphics design programs. This was apparently a Kickstarter project that, if you ask me, turned out quite well. It takes a lot of adjustment to try to switch between my main MX Blue keyboard and this one, but I do find it handy from time to time to use it and find the occasional shortcut I never even thought of, and save me some time editing. Plus, it's just nice to look down and see things directly relevant to what I'm doing. It's kind of a mental focusing thing. It is Windows and Mac compatible, and I used it with this iMac so I could actually shoot B-roll in my studio instead of my much less attractive office. But what the keyboard identifies as the command key for Mac does not translate to the command key on my iMac. The Windows/Alt key is the command key, and the command key is the Alt key. Now, this may not actually be a fault of Editor's Keys, as macOS seems to be ridiculously finicky about accepting keyboards, having me do tests and manual confirmation of the keyboard when I plug it in, and just rejecting half of my keyboards outright, but it's still a minor annoyance when I was already not used to using Mac in the first place. This is a great little keyboard, and I recommend it to anyone wanting to get serious about learning the NLE or just wants a simple visual reminder of the shortcuts. I hope you enjoyed this review. If you did, smash the like button, get subscribed for more awesome videos, and I will see you in the next one.